إن شاء الله we will continue with the tafsir from Juz' Amma. We are using tafsir Ibn Kathir, مختصر تفسير Ibn Kathir. To we're not bringing this from our opinion, this tafsir. It is just a simple tafsir in English, يعني translated in English, so that us people here in living in North America, most of us, we only know some surahs from Juz' Amma, or some of us have memorized Juz' Amma in its entirety, but this is what we mainly recite and use. So just to remind ourselves of the meaning, so that next time when we are reading these verses, we know what they mean. And we reached in Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, Surah إذا الشمس كورت, we reached to علمت نفس ما أحضرت. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on judgment day, everyone will know what they have brought forth. I mean, everyone will be fully aware. Their memory will be perfect of everything they have done and what they have brought forth. Another verse that supports the meaning of this is that تَجِدُ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ استعذ بالله ما عملت من خير محضرة وما عملت من سوء تود لو أن بينها وبينه أمدا بعيدا. Day when every person will find, will يعني what you, your deeds, not only you will have a book, they will materialize also. They will materialize. You will be able to see them, and if you deny them, even your own limbs and your skin and your everything will witness against you. So everyone will know exactly what they have brought on that day, and watawaddu, and they will wish that their deeds will be so far away from them. لو أن بينها وبينه أمدا بعيدا. And they would wish in earlier surah, when they are confronted with this reality, they will wish that they were dust, that they will not be account living, that they will not have existence. Allah. And then the surah goes, فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالْخُنَّسِ. And here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making qasam, means he is swearing by al-khunnas, al-jawari al-kunnas, wal-layli idha as'as, wal-subhi idha tanaffas, innahu laqawlu rasulin kareem, dhi quwwatin 'inda dhil 'arshi makin, muta'in thamma amin, wama sahibukum bimajnun, walaqad ra'ahu bil-ufuqi al-mubin, wama huwa 'ala al-ghaybi bidhanin, wama huwa biqawli shaytanir rajim, fa ayna tadhhabun, إن هو إلا ذكر للعالمين لمن شاء منكم أن يستقيم وما تشاءون إلا أن يشاء الله رب العالمين. Allah here is, verily I swear by the kunnas. And in tafsir, Sayyidina Anas, الجواري الكنس, اللهم صل على سيدنا. Ibn Jarir recorded from Khalid that he heard Ali, Sayyidina Ali, being asked about this, the meaning of khunnas and kunnas. And he said that these are stars. These are the stars that withdraw, disappear during the day, and during the night they are the sweeping across the sky. Al-jawar al-kunnas. So Allah is swearing by these specific stars. وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا عَسْعَسَ. And the night time, when عَسْعَس means it. There's two meanings here according to Sayyidina Ibn Kathir. Either when the night is ending or when the night is beginning. عَسْعَس. But most likely is when the night is beginning. Means when darkness takes over. والليل إذا عسعس والنهار اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد والصبح إذا تنفس، والليل إذا عسعس، والصبح إذا تنفس. And by the morning light when it تنفس when it appears when it takes over when the morning light comes. Brightness يعني of the day advances. إنه لقول رسول كريم. Verily, what this is the word of the most honorable messenger. إنه لقول رسول كريم. And here the meaning is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing that his most honor, his honorable angel Jibreel alayhi salam, who is the one who was given the task to deliver the wahi to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So innahu laqawlu rasulin kareem, that Sayyidina Jibreel is a very honored creation, very honored messenger, the quwwatin, very powerful, the quwwatin inda dhil arshi makin, he has a very special status with the Lord of the throne. He has a very high status and lofty rank with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here the Mufassir brings a couple of other verses from different surah that strengthen this meaning. عَلَّمَهُ سُورَةِ النَّجْمِ شَدِيدُ الْقُوَى ذُو مِرَّةٍ فَاسْتَوَى. That in another verse, surah النَّجْمِ, by the one who is very powerful, has very very strong, ذُو مِرَّةٍ, very mighty. And that is Sayyidina Jibreel. مُطَاعٍ ثَمَّ أَمِينٍ, and meaning that he has prestige and his words, Sayyidina Jibreel's words, are listened to, obeyed. He is obeyed amongst the most high gatherings of angel. مُطَاعٍ ثَمَّ أَمِينٍ, and he is also trustworthy. So he is نَمُو Al-A'zam, Ta'ala trusts him with his wahi for his prophets, for his messengers. He is described as Amin, Al-Aminu Jibreel alayhi salam. And this is also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has lavished praise on his most honored angel. Similarly, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in so many verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him so many titles and so many ranks and so many praise. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Verily, you have tremendous character. And Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, and so forth. So Sayyidina Jibreel here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is certified, he is the trustworthy one. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then the verses go to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he's addressing the unbelievers here. وَمَا صَاحِبُكُمْ بِمَجْنُونَ. And because they would sit around and say, what should we do? Should we call him crazy? Should we say he's a magician? Should we say he is a poet? What should we call him? So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so, وَمَا صَاحِبُكُمْ بِمَجْنُونَ. And verily, your companion, the one who lived amongst you all these years, he is not crazy. He is not مَجْنُون. اللهم صلي على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله. وَمَا صَاحِبُكُمْ بِمَجْنُونَ وَلَقَدْ رَآهُ بِالْأُفُقِ الْمُبِينَ. And indeed, he had seen the angel Jibreel on the horizon, meaning indeed Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw Jibreel, who brought him the message in the cave in the form of Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. He saw him in his real form as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not in what he dresses himself with to come with, but his actual real form. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said he had 600 wings. ولقد رآه بالأفق المبين in the clear horizon. He saw him. And this incident of that Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saw Sayyidina Jibreel in his real reality, real creation, is also mentioned in Surah An-Najm. علمه شديد القوى ذو مرة فاستوى وهو بالأفق الأعلى ثم دنا فتدلى. Say he was taught by Sayyidina Jibreel, ذو مرة, very powerful and mighty. فاستوى وهو, then he rose, and Sayyidina Jibreel, وهو بالأفق الأعلى, and when he was at the distant horizon. At the horizon, اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. And then he came closer, ثم دنا فتدلى, to Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now this here, some make ta'wil that the one who taught him is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the majority of ulama have said that it is Jibreel. But there are some tafsirs where it is mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allamahu shadidul quwa, that this refers to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who taught Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam drew nearer than two bows length to his Lord. فَأَوْحَى إِلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ مَا أَوْحَى, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed whatever he wanted to reveal to his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا هُوَ بِقَوْلِ شَيْطَانٍ رَجِيمٍ. Huh. وَمَا صَاحِبُكُمْ بِمَجْنُونٍ, and your Prophet is, and your companion is not crazy, and he saw Sayyidina Jibreel in his reality. وَمَا هُوَ عَلَى الْغَيْبِ بِضَنِينٍ, and this here is, can be read with a dha, بِضَنِينٍ, means he is not stingy with the ghayb, means what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is revealing to him to reveal to his ummah, he's not keeping for himself. And bidhanin, if you read it with the meaning of dha, wama huwa ala al-ghaybi bidhanin, means Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not fabricating anything about the unseen from himself. Yeah? It is only the truth that is Allah is revealing. Wama huwa biqawli shaytanin rajim, and whatever he is revealing to you is not from shayateen. Is not from a shaitan regime, from a rebellious shaitan. فَأَيْنَ تَذْهَبُونَ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, where can you run away from reality? Where can you turn your back onto the truth? How can you do this? إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرٌ لِلْعَالَمِينَ, verily, that what we are revealing is dhikr for all creation. لِمَنْ شَاءَ مِنْكُمْ أَنْ يَسْتَقِيمْ, for whoever wants to walk the straight path. وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ, and you do not will until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows you to will رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Here some of the verses at the end, people say, well, if I, you know, here the verse, the literal meaning can mean, اللهم صلي على سيدنا محمد, that وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ, means you do not will until Allah wills. So here some ta'ifa amongst the Muslim, they believe in qadariya, means that they have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills everything and we have no will to choose. But that's not what means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ, means you cannot will, you don't have the power to choose, except that Allah has granted you, has willed that you have the power to choose. And that's what distinguishes human being. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted us the ability to choose. وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's will is that we have the power to choose which path in this world to take, to deny, to accept, to believe, to disbelieve. It is fully our choice, and not on our own, because of our power we have the power to choose, because Allah granted us the power to choose. وَمَا هُوَ بِقَوْلِ شَيْطَانٍ رَجِيمٍ لمن شاء منكم أن يستقيم for whoever wills. So this is an indication that anyone who intends, who asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance, who wills, who chooses, who makes intention to do right, to be good, to seek the truth, to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant him that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide that person. In the early days when I came to Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, I was reading in one book that those who seek guidance with sincerity, Allah will definitely send them guidance through guides. And this is a reality. So people are inclined, whatever you're inclined, Allah will make it easy for you. Allah gave you the choice. So if you seek to waste your life, if you seek to only accumulate this world, if you seek to do evil things, whatever, Allah will let you. And if you seek the other path, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will. So it's always important to always our GPS to say, Ya Rabbi, I'm intending, I want to be a good servant of yours. This is my intention. I'm weak, and you are most generous one, most merciful one. Grant me the opportunity to be a true servant from you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is generous. Allah wants us to be guided. Allah wants us to make the right choice in our lives. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرٌ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Verily, it is a reminder for all creation. This Quran is a reminder for all creation, for whoever wants to be straight, to walk the straight path. وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا يَشَاءُ اللَّهُ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. May Allah grant us to be on the straight path, inshallah, dunya and akhirah. And the next chapter is Surah Al-Infitar. And as we said earlier, that Prophet ﷺ said, and this is, he mentions the hadith here in the tafsir, that Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ told Sayyidina Mu'adh, Mu'adh, أَفَتَّانٌ أَنْتَ يَا مُعَاذ, are you someone who causes people to, gives people hard time, makes trial for them? And because Sayyidina Mu'adh was reading Isha or Fajr prayer, and he was reading us, and Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the night prayer, Isha prayer, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, some people complained, and Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, why are you giving people a hard time, making it hard for them? He say, recite for them, Sabbih isma rabbika al-a'la, or al-duha, وَإِذَا السَّمَاءُ انْفَطَرَتْ. And then he said, وَإِذَا السَّمَاءُ انْفَطَرَتْ. This is the one surah that we're going to make tafsir of. Also, we mentioned that this surah is one of the three surahs Prophet mentioned that gives a full description of the Day of Judgment. And these three surahs are إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوِّرَتْ, انفطرت, and then إذا السماء انشقت. These three surahs are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving the description and the imagery of the Day of Judgment in them. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you want to witness, if you want somebody as if they are looking at the Day of Judgment, is in these three surahs. Inshallah, we will start with this surah tomorrow, if Allah permits us. ومن الله التوفيق بحرمة الفاتحة. صلي على محمد. Thank you all for joining us. بارك الله فيكم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Allah bless you.